Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we just ended wondering how do we identify the memory leak. In this particular video, we will actually find a mechanism of finding a memory leak. To do that, we have to be familiar with Android Studio. If you have used Android Studio for quite some time, you will observe that it will have a tool called as Android Monitor, where it shows you the state of various system resources like memory, CPU, network. The one that we are interested in is the memory analyzer. It comes with three options wherein you can initialize a garbage collection and then start and stop allocation tracking. And the third aspect is dumping a Java heap memory. The one that we are interested among these three is dumping the Java heap memory. And to find the memory leak, we will trigger a memory dump. After triggering the memory dump, we will analyze it using a tool called as HPROF. HPROF stands for heap profiling tool or CPU profiling tool. It basically runs over heap dump and gives you a easily understandable data. HPROF tool is not very specific to Android. This has been there in existence for quite some time. Java developers have been using this for quite some time. And if you are wondering whether I have to add any extra plugin to use this particular tool, then you need not have to worry about that because our Android Studio comes built with HPROF tool. So we have now a very basic understanding of how we are going to go about this. So it is time that we get into a quick demo and see how it happens. I have created a project called as Context Demo. It is nothing but a simple Hello World application. There is nothing much here. Now we will be writing a code here to create memory leak. So I have a class called as some random sample class. I will create this class so that it is a singleton class. So let me get started with it. Private static some random class instance, and then I will create a private context instance, and I will have a private constructor for this particular class. I will use the context as the argument, and it will initialize context here, and then I will have a public method which returns me the static instance. So public some random class get random class instance, I will pass context as the argument. Then if this instance is equal to null, then only initialize the instance and then return the instance. So we are done with the class, and now in the main activity I will create a some random class instance, and we have to initialize this some random class dot. I think we are not able to call this particular method because it is not static, so let me make it static, and then I should be able to call this particular method and pass this particular code. Looks pretty innocent, but this is going to cause the memory leak. So let me run this particular application and let me open Android Monitor. The application got launched and you can see that this is the memory allocation of the application. Now what we will do is change the orientation of the application once, and then we will cause a memory dump. And as you can see here, this is where the memory dump was caused. It actually opens a HPROF file automatically. So give it a time and you can just maximize that particular screen, and you will see quite a number of windows here. The one that we are interested in here is analyze tasks, and you can only select detect leaked activities and click on this button which looks like a play button. You can see analysis result leaked activities. If you click, it will show where exactly the memory leak happened. Some random class sample in the main activity memory leak is happening. This is how you identify a memory leak in your Android application. Doing this analysis is quite a cumbersome task. We did it for just one simple application where it was a very simple class. But in a real world scenario, you might have written huge application running into hundreds of classes. So this particular methodology will not be actually very efficient when you are working in a production code. So how to do it in a much better manner, we will see it in the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.